announcement is.
It's time for spring cleaning. So since the church hasn't been cleaned since about 2019, and the exterior updates are starting, it's time for us to get busy on the inside cleaning up. So Sunday, May 21st, you are all invited to the St. Clement's Church cleanup beginning after the 8:15 service. After the 8:15 service, we can start doing cleaning things that are not the sanctuary. There's going to be coffee and pastries. And then we're going to continue after the 10:30 service all the way until 2 o'clock in the afternoon. And then you should come back for the evensong that evening.
And it is a family affair. We do have child care until 2 o'clock. And also, we have a project for the littles. The larger littles will be helping the younger littles with alphabetizing the name tag.
Wait, we have name tags.
We have name tags. If you don't have a name tag and you would like a name tag, we will make a sign-up sheet for that as well and get them ordered for you.
And so if I've inadvertently been calling you off because there are like 8 of them, it'd be helpful to you and to me if you wear your name tag so I can now call you Mike.
Or just call Mike.
On the cleanup day. Thank you, guys.
Thank you. from Acts. But filled with the Holy Spirit, he gazed into heaven and saw the glory of God and Jesus standing at the right hand of God. "Look," he said, "I see the heavens open and the Son of Man standing at the right hand of God." But they covered their ears, and with a loud shout, all rushed together against him. Then they dragged him out of the city and began to stone him. And the witnesses laid their coats at the feet of a young man named Saul. While they were stoning Stephen, he prayed, "Lord Jesus, receive my spirit." Then he knelt down and cried out in a loud voice, "Lord, do not hold this sin against them." When he had said this, died. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
God's own people, in order that you may proclaim the mighty acts of him who called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. Once you were not a people, but now you are God's people. Once you had not received mercy, but now you have received mercy. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Father who dwells in me does his works. believe me that I am in the Father and the Father is in me. But if you do not, then believe me because of the works themselves. Very truly I tell you, the one who believes in me will also do the works that I do, and in fact will do greater works than these, because I am going to the Father. I will do whatever you ask in my name, so that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If in my name you ask me for anything, I will do it. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Thank you.
danger. In a world where they missed deeply their friend Stephen would die, they wanted to imagine that neighborhood, that kingdom of God, where everybody would be made whole. I go to prepare a place for you. In my father's house, there are many rooms. In my neighborhood, there are many homes. And no one I've ever loved will ever die. We, like the early Christians, long to make meaning of this reality we are in. We long to see again those who have gone before us. We long to be connected by a community of love. Connected, always. Whether we take the wings of the morning or dwell in the parts of the sea, together. And that is when my heart breaks for the disciples. Because they were like us in their longings and their yearnings. I'm pretty sure some of them probably wanted ponies and never got them. So they asked their friend Jesus, this place, you described, this house with all the rooms where we all get to live and Stephen's there too, how are we going to get there? They just want to know, how are they going to get there? And Jesus tells them, if you know me, you'll know the way. If you know me, you will know the way. Which brings the question, how do we know Jesus? How will we know the way? By knowing Jesus. Do you remember the part in the Gospel of John where it says, Christ abides in you? Is that, I abide in you as you abide in me? It's Jesus saying it. I abide in you as you abide in me, right? I think we know the way through a relationship with each other. Through the connections we build and the lives we share. Because in that encounter, we see Christ. When we know love for and with our neighbors and friends and loved ones, we get to know Christ more fully. And so in those relationships, we find the way. And I am convinced that when we move from light to light and love to love and life to life, we are following the way of love that we have learned in the here and the now. How many of you know the story of Hansel and Gretel? Those breadcrumbs along the way. Now, in the original version, they are eaten by breadcrumbs. It does not end well. But this is the deal. I imagine these little breadcrumbs of love that we just follow along to find a way. Little tiny moments of grace and hope made manifest that remind us that death is not the end of the story and that we will, in fact, be together again. We will know the way to that kingdom. That kingdom where we can all be together in the fullness of love. There's another place in Scripture where it says, now I see through a mirror dimly, but soon I will see you face to face. It's that place in the fullness of love. And I don't know what it'll be like. I don't know if there'll be 7-day weekends or 3-day weekends. I don't know if everybody's going to get a kitten in a jetpack. But what I do know is that by knowing all of you, and by knowing what love is in the here and the now, I will find a way. And so will all of you.
one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally God the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten from not made, of one being the Father, through him all things made, for us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified on the Mount of Pilate, he suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for forgiveness of sins. We look for resurrection together in the life of the world to come. Amen.
In peace we pray to you, Lord God.
In our prayers this morning, we invite you to offer your own prayers after each bidding, whether silently, aloud, or in the chat in Zoom. I ask your prayers for God's people throughout the world, for Michael, our presiding bishop, and for Craig, our bishop, for this gathering, and for all ministers and people. Pray for the church.
For Brian and Elizabeth and their cohort who are preparing for ordination to the priesthood next month.
I ask your prayers for peace, for goodwill among nations, and for the well-being of all people. Pray for justice and peace. I ask your prayers for the poor, the sick, the hungry, the oppressed, and those in prison. Pray for those in any need or trouble. I ask your prayers for all who seek God for a deeper knowledge of him. Pray that they may find and be found by him.
I give thanks for our Sunday school teachers.
I ask your prayers for the departed. Pray for those who have died. I ask for your prayers and thanksgivings.
For the beautiful weather. For the gift of a multi-generational community.
For the teachers.
For students who are finishing up finals and taking the last of their AP exams.
Praise God for those in every generation in whom Christ has been honored. Pray that we may have grace to glorify Christ in our own day.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I give to you, my own peace I leave with you. Regard not our sins, but the faith of your church, and give to us the peace and unity of that heavenly city, where with the Father and the Holy Spirit you live and reign, now and forever. Amen." May the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Please share with one another a sign of God's peace. who sacrificed for us and has taken away the sin of the world. By his death, he has destroyed that. And by rising to life again, he has won for us everlasting life. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels of all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name.
Amen.
Arthur, continue to